welcome to the Scoutout. A little later on, Mrs. Thompson will be telling us about her holiday in Sardinia, but first some music.
1982, the year Statement Hair and the Look at Me generation took over Top of the Pops. While the show itself went into overdrive.
Suddenly you see this man's got the whole studio.
If you watch it, it's just a live tape, one shot, and I don't think that had been done before.
The kids from Fame embraced the show.
Hi to everyone on Top of the Pops.
And inspired the cheerleaders. And a featured dancer walked on the moon.
They didn't know if something was pulling me backwards, if I had oil on the floor, or if I had wheels on my shoes.
It was a golden year for new pop. Top of the Pops crammed with transformation, conceptualization, and aspiration.
There were very dour grey times back then. So Thursday night, 7:30, blam, you know.
And it was capped by the stunning debut of the biggest new icon of the decade.
I did hear stories of people having cups of tea literally dropping them in their lap going, what is that?
Like a jungle sometimes. It makes me wonder how I keep from going under.
82 was a big year for a new American sound known back then as electro. As the first records crossed the Atlantic, the cheerleaders and dancers of Top of the Pops treated them as they would any other dance record, until Shalamar entered the charts. The band's singer Jodie was pregnant and couldn't make the show, but Michael Hurl took a chance on guitarist and street dancer Jeffrey Daniel's offer to demonstrate a whole new set of dance moves, alone.
I got into my hotel room, and I just listened to the song, and I just worked out a routine that I wanted to do. So I began it as preparing myself to go out. So I'm like, I'm in the mirror, I'm fixing myself up, I'm doing my hair. So I'm kind of like reenacting the theme of the song. When you love someone, it's natural, not demanding. I go back, I do the wall climber. Then I go back and I put my coat on. I had someone holding my jacket for me. And then I slip into my jacket. Okay, I'm ready, let's go. And then that's when I went into the back cocking, where I cocked back like that. And then bring myself back up again. I knew that there's a music breakdown in the middle of the song with the bass. Boom, 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 boom. So there's a music breakdown. So I saved that part of the song to do the backslide. And so I set it up, and when I knew it was coming,
so all the kids are going, wow, that looks great. How do you do that? And that's the first time, I believe, it had been shown on British TV.
I even got one of the dancers to handcuff me at the end of the song and drag me into the backslide across the floor. The impact that it had on the public was that they didn't know if something was pulling me backwards, if I had oil on the floor, if I had wheels on my shoes. They couldn't work out how I was doing this backslide. So we flew over to Amsterdam to continue our promotion. While we were in Amsterdam, the record company came banging on my hotel door. He said, Jeffrey, man, everyone's looking for you. I said, what's happening? What did I do? He said, no, we have to go back to the UK. That performance you did on Top of the Pops yesterday has everybody buzzing.
A couple of weeks ago, Jeffrey Daniels from Shalamar danced his way onto the program, and we've had hundreds of letters from people asking for him back. Well, he is back, moving to his music, A Night to Remember.
Then he was brought back, which is a really unusual phenomena, through public demand. Public demanded to see this man dance. And so the song was used as a backdrop to him. Normally dancing is used as a package for the product. He became the product. Let's make a toast.
because of my performance on Top of the Pops, somebody else was watching me. So Michael actually wanted to learn a lot, all of the dancing. He wanted to learn popping, you know. He wanted to learn waving, ticking. And of course, after we taught Michael Jackson the backslide, so he names it the Moonwalk. And once again, he waited for the breakdown. When he did it on the Motown 25th, that was 1983, and that's the first time he did it. And I was in the audience and I was watching. So it was the beginning of this new dance revolution, which was going on with the graffiti artists, which was going on with the DJs scratching and breakbeating everything. That was the groundwork, which is now called hip-hop.